All right, hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Take Two. We started this game before, and I forgot to talk into Ventrilo, so Cholera was like, what the heck, man? Are you saying anything? What's going on? This is game five of the All-Star Match, the Pro League All-Star Match Zero, and away we go. And this is a game between two of my favorite players, actually. This is a game between Kal and Lomo. And a few months ago, if you'd said, dude, Lomo's going to be your favorite player in a few months, I would have been like, you are on crack, sir. You need to stop smoking the crack and get help soon. But Lomo came from being pretty much a mediocre cookie-cutter Terran that didn't really accomplish anything and came out with some spectacular, very, very interesting play recently and has really impressed me a lot. Kal, on the other hand, again, impressing me a lot recently. He's kind of come out as one of the major players in the StarCraft scene in the last couple seasons. And also some very, very innovative play. One of my favorite things about Kal is that he is really, really smart. He is really good at changing his tactics depending on what the other guy is doing and outsmarting him in that sense. So should be a very, very interesting match. I'm anxious to see what kind of crazy stuff both these players can pull out here.
Yeah, just looking back at the games, Kal and Lomo have actually had no history against one another, so definitely going to be interesting to see how both of these rather creative players deals with each other. I would definitely say that Lomo has not played standard StarCraft in recent months, and that's definitely been to his advantage, and Kal has never done that as far as I know. I think he's just a very creative player. I mean, he's the one player who's done a cannon rush on Colosseum and actually beaten someone with it. Pretty crazy. check it out. I don't know what game it was, but he did build like a cannon on top of someone's ridge. But anyway, this map Andromeda, by the way, is a bit imbalanced towards, well, not imbalanced, but favors Protoss. Out of the 38 games that have been played, 24 have been won by Protoss and 14 by Terran in this matchup. Looks like Kal's going to scout in the wrong direction here. And Kal really has a lot of options on this map. I think the Protoss player generally has basically one of two strong options. The first is to deny the Terran a fast expand. If he senses the Terran's going to go for a fast expand, the Protoss should go for something like a DT drop or a Reaper drop, and that's just proven absolutely devastating in recent months, especially DT drop, fast DT drop, to counter the Terran fast expand, because the Terran just really doesn't have the detection to spare. The other thing, of course, the Protoss can do is go for a fast expand himself and pick up probably a fast double expand, get both of those expansions up as soon as possible, and try to win a macro game against the Terran in the mid game. So I think both are good options, and we are seeing shots of the coaches. I believe Samson Khan's coach is going to be the coach of, I'm going to guess it's, actually I'm not going to guess, I'm pretty sure it is going to be Challenge, so Kal's coach for this, and the other one's going to be the coach for whatever, for Lomo. But anyway, so Kal now getting a scout in the last position there. He's going to see what Lomo's up to. Lomo looks like he's got one Marine on the ramp. That's going to ward away that probe there. We'll see if Lomo decides to do anything tricky or if he's going to go for that rather standard Terran fast expand with after the factory. And from what I see so far, they're not showing us the gas, but I'm going to guess with just one factory up that's probably going to be the fast expand.
Yeah, that makes perfect sense. And Stork also has a Dragoon on his ramp now. He looks like he's upgrading range, so he's going to go for a pretty standard safe build here as well, is what it looks like. I think I just said Stork. I meant Kal. We just did game four with Stork, so I'm used to saying Stork all the time. Lomo, looks to be... I missed it. They just showed his gas, but I missed it. But yeah, it's pretty, pretty standard for Protoss to at least get one quick expansion on this map. Because what they can do is they can take their mineral-only expansion, and it's really not very much of a risk because they can still have a ramp then. That's one of the main problems with the fast expanding is usually the expansion is lower down from a ramp. And actually, Lomo getting a lot of gas here, actually. He's not actually, it doesn't look like he's setting up for a fast expansion after all. I wouldn't be surprised if we put if we see him put down starports or something like that in the not too distant future, because he hasn't put anything down yet, so he's got to be saving up for something. I don't know, maybe he is saving up for an expansion after all, because otherwise we would have seen some sort of other buildings, I think. It's hard to say. But yeah, never mind. Okay, I'm completely wrong. There's the command center. He's just decided to make it a little bit slower by not delaying his gas, is what it looked like. Or maybe I'm just completely on crack. But yeah, point being though that when you fast expand as a Protoss, the risk is that it's lower down, it's harder to protect. But when you have that ramp that can protect both your main and your natural, like on a map like this, it's really easy to pull off. And so I wouldn't be surprised if we see Cal put down an expansion sometime pretty soon here. He's really desperate to get that scout in. Again, losing another probe here, trying to get a scout in. He's being very tricksy about trying to get that probe into his base, waiting for those Marines to move out, and then trying to come in behind and get into Lomo's base to see what he's doing. Against the player like Lomo, it's really important to know what they're doing. So really smart move there. It looks like Lomo's just content to kind of protect his base here with some mines. He's not trying to push out with his tank and Marines or anything like that. He's just going to chill and box Cal in and pull off whatever he's going to pull off sometime pretty soon. I'm anxious to see what he's going to start planting now, what his plans are going to be.
Yeah, I think... Yeah, I really don't know what he's planning to be at, but I do know that Lomo is powered by bubblegum. He is known as the bubblegum Terran.
Heck yeah.
And if he ever stops chewing gum, he just, like, his hands literally stop working. It's just a terrible condition, but it's one that he has. It looks like Cal went for a very, very conservative build there, fast observers. And this is a build, well, we do see it somewhat often, but usually when the Terran fast expands, we've been seeing a lot of aggressive Protoss openers. I thought for a second he was going to go for Reavers, but he's gone for the fast observers, which isn't a bad build at all either. Unfortunately for him, though, he's going to be a little bit behind on the gas production on the tech units because he's opted for the first expansion inside of his base. Cal's actually from the minimap, looks like he is setting up the natural expansion with gas now, but... So unfortunately, though, for him, that Lomo decided to go for the fast expand, and he's going to be a little bit behind now. Quick Stargate going up, though, for Cal, and I have to think this is going to be for carriers here. So we're going to see fast carriers from Cal. Absolutely interesting play here, but I don't think this is going to work. I mean, he barely has that second gas up. Man, I just don't know what Cal's plans are here. Maybe he's going to build some scouts like he did against 4GG. No, just kidding. But, by the way, part of showing what how Cal is such a strong player, he canceled his target. Yeah. That's very important. And now he's building a robotic support bay. Wow, that's strange. I don't know what would have made him cancel that Stargate. I mean, I can't imagine him doing it accidentally. Producing a Stargate accidentally. But anyway, my point I was just going to try to say is Cal is the player who's taken 4GG the farthest in the last MSL. He almost beat 4GG in a 3-2 series, whereas, obviously Flash just got, ripped through by 4GG, and so did Jadong. So that definitely speaks to Cal's abilities. But anyway, so Cal is going to be going for the very late Reavers, and he's just been doing a very, very nothing build so far this game. Very uncharacteristic, not taking advantage so far. And, that weird little building a Stargate and canceling it, just very strange. And his, I don't know how good his late Reavers are going to be at this point. But we are seeing a battle come up, and I'll let Moletrap commentate it.
Yeah, really quickly taking out both the tanks there. Lomo looking shocked. He's like, you can see it on his face. He's like, OMFG, those are my tanks, dude. Picking off those two tanks really quickly in the beginning of the battle. I don't think Lomo expected to find those Dragoons in the middle of the map there. And so getting a little bit caught off guard there. And unfortunately, though, let's see. Oh, he does manage to get the Vultures in. I didn't think he was going to get him in for a second there. But he does get some Vultures in, so at the very least, he's going to be able to scout around and see what's going on. He's going to be able to take out a few probes as well. And Reaver, with a little shield of tech buildings in the way, is going to be able to take out those Vultures and drive the last one off, limping away. Lomo, though, it looks like Lomo, he's not trying for anything tricksy after all. He's just planted down four more factories, so he's up to five factories. He may have even planted down a sixth right now. So it looks like Lomo's just going to kind of be doing your standard bulking up sort of standard Terran thing. I think it's going to be probably to his advantage in the long run because Cal is playing really conservatively, as you said, and so he doesn't have a lot of forces on the ground. He still only has three bases as well. And I think that Lomo's probably going to have the advantage here. He's doing a kind of a slow push, it looks like, setting up some turrets and mines in the middle of the map. But we'll see if Cal can manage anything with these Reavers in the shuttle coming in here. And Cal going in here with a little bit haphazardly losing a couple Dragoons at the very beginning of the attack. His Zealots are not even speed upgraded. Shuttle coming in with the Reavers. The shuttle is about to go down. Both Reavers pop! Both Reavers pop! Oh my goodness, and that was Cal's only major advantage he had now. He's going to be able to push in a little bit here, but as soon as those tanks siege up, Cal's going to get pushed back again. That was absolutely ridiculous. Both players playing a little bit sloppy here, I think, but Cal running his shuttle across the top of the turret, losing his shuttle, dropping the Reavers out of desperation, and then having them get just basically popped by target firing from Lomo's troops there. I don't think they even got a scarab off. I didn't see if they did, but I don't think they even got a scarab off. So Lomo with a definite advantage here, in my opinion. He's got a little bit more of an economic advantage, I think, and at the same time, he's just won a major battle and destroyed all of the tech units that Cal's built for the entire game.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely give the favorite to Lomo, and we did see a Stargate go up for Cal, so Cal might be thinking about, once again, sort of indecisive this game, but might be thinking about those carriers now, and yeah, we are going to see that fleet beacon, so I really think he would have been better off going for carriers right in the beginning, skipping the Reaver stage, but I guess he wanted to try for a Reaver shuttle break there. I also do think that Lomo actually wasn't just playing sloppily. I did see him plant some mines next to where those Reavers landed. I think he was just microing very quickly there, got like three mines down right next to the Reavers, and that was part of the reason why they just absolutely popped, as you said. And really, right now, the carriers are very much slower. And you know, obviously, they're much later than they would have been had he gone for them first. And I don't know. I think Lomo has scanners. I think he's going to be using them very soon. And he's going to, you know, either suspect Templars or carriers, and he's going to see the carriers. And Lomo now has the center of the map. Cal has played a little bit careless so far this game. He's gotten lots of Dragoons killed off by tank fire. And right now, since Lomo has played quite well so far, he's really made any mistakes. He's gotten him in a contained position, and he can't pick up a third gas, and that is really, really going to be hard to. It's going to be really hard for him to macro any number of carriers off of just two gas without there being some kind of crazy, like stork-like rush. I think Cal is just going to be is going to find a really up-road battle here to try to take this game.
Yeah, this is going to get crazy pretty soon though, because it looks like Lomo, he is going for containment. We're probably going to see him start pushing in before too long once he gets some more tanks. To try and close the noose of this containment there. And that's exactly when Cal's carriers are going to start coming out. So it's going to be a basically a kind of a crazy last-second push of Cal to try and break out with carriers. And it looks like Cal, in the meantime, he's discovered a hole in the containment. He's barreled a bunch of forces down into Lomo's front choke there. I don't think it's going to be too much... I don't think it's going to do a whole lot of damage here. I don't think Cal's going to be able to do too much damage. Oh, there's a Reaver there, actually. The Reaver goes off, killing a couple shuttles. Lomo not looking terribly phased, but not exactly looking excited about this situation either. I think he's playing it pretty cool for the most part. That's one of the reasons I like him, too. He tends to be pretty good. Oh, Reaver in the back gets the Scarab off. No damage. Tank takes out the Reaver, so this is going to get cleaned up pretty well. But I think, crucially, the main thing that happened here is that this has bought Cal some time, some crucial time, to get those carriers up and running. They've been working up interceptors. They popped out of the Stargates a minute ago. So they are probably nearly finished building up those interceptors there. And so he's going to be able to come out. And also, I think he's managed to draw back Lomo's forces from that containment as well. So you can see he's actually pushing out here. He might not even be done yet, but there's too many vultures, so he is going to get pushed back a little bit here. But again, the containment has been kind of broken here. It's bought a lot of time for Lomo in that aspect. And there come the carriers. Carriers coming out now here to take care of these forces. We're going to see if he's building... he's still no Goliaths out for Lomo at all. And there's the carriers. We're going to see how Lomo reacts here. Lomo looks completely surprised. He had no idea that these carriers were coming. He has nothing to combat them. And it looks like he's going for kind of a last ditch, trying to attack with his ground units before they die, because it is inevitable that they're just going to get picked off by these carriers there. Lomo completely caught unprepared for these carriers when they came out.
Yeah, I have to say, Lomo is definitely not like Zealous or Savior. He keeps his emotions on his face. He definitely has no poker face there. And we just saw him possibly swallow his gum there. Just in shock once he saw the carriers come out. And, yeah, those carriers are going to wipe out the tanks off the face of the map here. And, really, it's going to be a scramble now for Lomo to try to build enough wraiths, to try to build something. I mean, either wraiths or goliaths or something to shoot up. And, of course, I think a player like Cal is going to be trying to press the vantage in as soon as possible. Looks like Cal's got a couple more carriers, too, so probably up to four carriers now. And right now, we still have absolutely nothing from Lomo in terms of anti-air. He's probably getting his first Goliaths out right now, trying to build some get mines in the middle to try to slow things down, but that's not going to stop. Mines are not going to stop these carriers from getting into his base, and really what the Terran player needs to do if the Proton Slayer goes carriers is to scout it early, and Lomo, I think, made a grave error by not scanning. He had three command centers. He could have gotten tons of scans off all around Cal's base and found out that there were carriers coming 5 minutes ago when he had a definite lead, and I think it would have I think actually the carriers were a desperation move, and I think really Lomo could have finished them off, finished off these couple of carriers that are leaking out, but because he didn't scan, I think he is going to lose his game here, and what a turn of events here for Cal.
Yeah, when you're a Terran, you really need to scout that ahead of time, and I mean, this is the reason why you need to scout that ahead of time, because you can't start building Goliaths when you see the carriers. You have to start building them before you see the carriers, so you have several out. Because here we see, I mean, this is the proof. There's a few Goliaths out, but there's just nothing they can do about these carriers. They're not even hiding behind ridges or anything. Cal just going straight in the front door with the carriers, backing up with the Dragoons as well. It looks like Lomo is probably going to lose this base. He's probably going to lose the game at this point. Yeah, and it's just a little bit too late. If he'd scouted it earlier, he would have been able to react. And there's Stork and Best. We were talking before about how their all-star team contains a lot of the best Protoss players, and Cal, one of them taking out. And here we go. I think this is the final blow. Some Zealots going up to attack that base at the 9 o'clock position, and that was the only advantage that Lomo had. There we go. GG from Lomo. He still was had a lot of economy, even though he'd taken a hit to his front door. But losing that base, he realizes that there was just nothing he could do. So Cal takes the win, and I noticed that Lomo had stopped chewing his gum. I think he did swallow his gum in surprise when when those carriers showed up, because I didn't see him chewing his gum at any point after that. And like you said, that was his power, so he just could not resist without his gum power to keep him moving.
Yeah, I have to say, the Bubblegum Terran fails, unfortunately. But Cal, what a great comeback. I mean, this is not exactly Stork's two base carriers, because Stork did it a whole lot faster than Cal did. But what I thought was kind of a desperation move actually turned out to really work quite well. And I have to say, must be a little embarrassing for Lomo, but he's still a young kid. I'm sure he'll come back from this. Anyway, hope you guys enjoyed. I got nothing else to say, so good game.